Nityanandeshwarasamarambham Nityanandeshwari Madhyamam Asmadacharya Parayantam Vande Guru Paramparam. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanedars, visitors, viewers, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, and two-way video conferencing having Nayanadiksha. City sitting with us, having Nayanadiksha, Godalu Prameshwaram, Nityananda University, Los Angeles, Ohio Prayag, Singapore, Singapuram, San Jose, Madurai, Charlotte, Sri Sailam, Tanjavur, Nityananda Dhyana Beetam, Thiruvannamalai, and lot more cities. More and more when they many more are online. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, 9th day of the Navratri Utsava and 7th day of the Venkateshwara Brahmotsava, Venkateshwara is gracing all of us in Swarana Hamsavahana, the golden swan vehicle, and Devi is gracing us in the form of Mahasaraswati with Lakshmi and Saraswati serving her. She is gracing all of us in the form of Mahasaraswati. Let's receive their grace and blessings and enter into the satsang. Today I wanted to expand on the importance of Navratri and significance of Navratri. Devi the ultimate pure feminine consciousness. Of course, consciousness is beyond masculine and feminine. Ultimate pure expression of consciousness. These 9 days, the special door opens for all of us to experience that consciousness. The special possibility opens, that consciousness is available for us to experience, explore. to awaken the Di, Buddhi, in all of us. Di means in Sanskrit, the awakened intelligence. Intelligence which is functioning from the space of completion. Intelligence which is established in the Advaita Satya is called Di. Dikshanya, Di, that word means intelligence which is functioning from the space of Advaita. Intelligence which is awakened from the space of Advaita. எல்லையில்லாத சுத்த ஸ்வயம் பிரகாச ஞான பரவெளி, த தமிழ் வேர்ட் விச் ஐ எக்ஸ்பிரஸ் நவ் திஸ் இஸ் த டெஃபினேஷன் The Atma Purana, the four Upanishadic Tamil translation and commentary, which uses, this is the word I myself studied at the young age, to define the Parashakti. That is why spontaneously I uttered that word. Boundaryless, experientially possible, consciousness. It's available for all of us, especially on these Navaratri days. All you need to do in this Navaratri days, please listen, to experience that consciousness, the pain of your tapas, the incompletions and impossibilities you carry towards your tapas should be completed. Listen. All of us, all of you will be carrying that incompletion. I tried but failed. I did this tapas but failed. I was thinking to do this, I did not. I think it seems little impossible for me. Navaratri is the time to complete with that. All the incompletions related to your tapas, all the incompletions related to your incompletions need to be completed. Listen. All the incompletions related to your incompletions need to be completed. Navaratri is the time for that. All these impossibilities need to be completed. Once you complete all the impossibilities, and all the incompletions you have about your incompletions. Understand, incompletions you have about your incompletions need to be completed. Navaratri is the time for that. Navaratri is the space for that. Navaratri is the energy for that. Navaratri is the time where you can complete with all your incompletions. Especially the incompletions about the incompletions. It's a beautiful opportunity to complete with all the incompletions about the incompletions. Incompletions about the incompletions. More than your incompletions, your beliefs about your incompletions, your incompletions about your incompletions are the biggest obstacle. More than the fear, your fear about the fears. More than the incompletions, your incompletions about incompletions. That keeps you incomplete. It is time you all complete that. One more thing. If you want Mahadeva's grace, you have to complete all your incompletions. But if you want Devi's grace, even if you try to complete with your incompletions, or even if you act as if you are trying to complete your incompletions, she'll come down and grace you. Because Mahadeva will leave the what he has to give you, and you have to stretch and pick up and put it in your mouth. Devi is not like that. Even if you just stretch your hand and do some act like this here and there, immediately she will come down. Hey, come on, what do you want? And she is available so powerfully. And this Navaratri, especially till day after tomorrow evening, yesterday evening by Sabdami, the energy goes up and Ashtami, Navami, Dasami, Dasami evening only. Till this time, these 3 days, so powerfully available. Decide to complete with all your incompletions about incompletions. Pains related to your tapas, pains related to your spiritual practices, pains related to your attempts and failures. Trial and error methods. If you tried something and failed, you will carry incompletion about it. If you plan and did not achieve, you may carry certain incompletions about it. If you plan and fail and get caught in the impossibility pattern, it is time for you to complete with it. See, even believing impossibility is one more pattern. Complete with that. Complete with it. You would have never imagined, even forget about you, and I would have never imagined suddenly ashramites will give such a beautiful bhajan sessions and performance. And today they gave such beautiful performance. I just sat in samadhi, I forgot that I have to start the satsang. That's why it went on and on and on. See, when in Vedaranyam, Jnana Sambandhar and Appar, two saints are singing. Appar was trying to open the door. He sang a lot of songs, only then door opened. Jnana Sambandhar wanted to close the door by singing. He sang two songs, immediately the door got closed. So everyone thought, why it took so many songs for Appar to open the door and Jnana Sambandhar only few songs to close the door? Is Appar not that evolved spiritually soul? Immediately Mahadeva gives Asariri saying, no, no, I just lost myself in the songs of Appar. So I did not remember to respond. So today almost like that, I was just lost and I did not even remember that I had to start the satsang. After all, they are sannyasis and they may not have efficiency, but they are carrying that fire of sannyas. Efficiency can be added immediately the moment stupidity is completed. See, actually we voluntarily celebrate stupidity. To tell you the truth, we voluntarily celebrate the existence of stupidity. We think by having an inner image, I am a small guy, we think we can avoid the problems of life. See, whenever we encountered life, shrinking was the response we adopted. From the young age, when life tries to corner us, oh, I am a small boy, I am a small girl, I am a small person, I don't know anything, I am innocent, I don't know. That was the natural response with which we try to escape. That is why we celebrate stupidity. We always think if we just claim innocence and don't know anything and claim a frightened child victimhood and be innocent, ignorant, stupid, problems won't come to us, people will leave us, we will get the sympathy and we won't be attacked. This is the most sinful lesson human beings have been taught. I can tell you, this is the most sinful addiction human beings get. I will put this addiction as worse than alcoholism, womanizing, any other addiction. This addiction to victimhood and strongly believing if you claim victimhood, life will let go you. Life will not hold you responsible. Every time see inside you, when you take responsibility, when you get the fear or the anxiety, what will others tell, what will everyone tell, and if they attack me, what can I do? Your first response and plan will be claim innocence. Then they can't do anything. Nothing can be done. But I tell you, this pattern is the worst pattern human beings suffer. Whenever any of my ashramites or sannyasis, anybody in our sangha claims this innocence, victimhood, I didn't know what happened, I just tried to do what I am trying. Whenever people claim, I see Bhasmasura in them. They are not innocent as they pose. They have developed a powerful pattern which can destroy them and others. Understand? This claiming innocence and trying to be, oh, I didn't know, that is why this happened. I didn't know, that is why it failed. I didn't take the responsibility, that is why it happened. I didn't know how to take the responsibility, I didn't know how to do it. They are worse than snakes. Snakes will have poison only near the teeth. These fellows will have poison all over the body, because claiming victimhood is one of the most poisonous pattern you develop, and you think it is cute and great, which is wrong. Completely wrong. Whoever gets out of that pattern becomes Mahadeva. Decides to take the responsibility. Mahadeva purposely applies ash, wears this Rudraksha bead, lives in Smashana. His whole lifestyle, you see, purposely he tells the world he is not perfect. Is complete. Actually, perfection is one of the side effects of completion. But he just wants to tell the world, I am not interested in showing me perfect. My first priority is to show I am complete. Perfection is usually the side effect of completion. But he doesn't want to put the perfection in the front. He puts the completion in the front. Understand? Completion means being responsible, never leaning on the victimhood. If you are leaning on the victimhood, never expect any good thing from life. It's only completion which can help you. When you are progressing in some steps, doing something, if there is an attack, stand responsible. Don't immediately claim innocence and frightened. No. I don't know. No. Stand responsible. You will be Mahadeva. You are Shiva. You are profiling is more important than your actions. Profiling means what you are is more important than what your success is or what your actions are. screaming, frightened child, claiming frightened victimhood, claiming frightened innocence and ignorance, hiding behind, I don't know. This pattern, this addiction is worse than alcoholism and womanizing and serial murdering patterns, I tell you. This one claiming powerless and innocent and I don't know, this pattern, once developed, it is atmahatya. Atmahatya means don't think suicide, no. Destroying your consciousness. Once you do that sin, you will not be bothered to do any other sin. You will not be bothered to kill, you will not be bothered to womanize, you will not be bothered to be drunk, you will not be bothered to do panchama patakas. The claiming frightened victimhood, childhood, claiming frightened childhood, frightened ignorance, innocence, should be completed now. Anything you progress, yes, life will question, ask, others will ask, stand for it. Only then you will move forward. Every time when you are asked, you are frightened and back out. Then what do you think you are going to be doing? What do you think you are going to be achieving? What do you think you are going to be progressing? Stop claiming frightened childhood. Stop claiming innocence as the route to escape from life. Stop claiming ignorance as the route to escape from life. That pattern is the worst pattern, original sin. Stand as a complete being. Anybody who stands as a complete being without claiming innocence, ignorance, frightened childhood, are stupid. These kind of patterns . Anybody who does not claim this kind of patterns and fall into this kind of patterns is Mahant. This is the definition of Mahant. He is the leader who takes it forward, who takes it further. Takes responsibility, stands up. Otherwise, just listening to my satsang is useless unless you make it into reality. Make it into reality. So with this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
நித்யானந்த தியான பீட்டம், நித்யானந்த நகர், ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட், விடதி, பெங்களூரு. ஃபோன் 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.